is like a rice bake instead of a pasta bake.
If you don't have a tub this big full of leftover mince, what are you doing? Basically mix the rice and mince together, add more or less depending on what consistency you want. Bang in a huge handful of grated cheddar cheese, add it all to an oven-proof dish,
flatten out the top, add some more cheese.
You can add whatever you want here, I'm going to just hit it with some black pepper and some basil.
About 40 minutes in the oven at 180 degrees,
and drop a like and a follow.
Insanely delicious one pot pasta. Start by chopping some onions. I'm going to go for mushrooms and spinach because that's what I've got in the fridge. Chop up the spinach finely so it's not too stringy, and peel and chop some garlic. Heat up some olive oil, then get the onions in to sweat. Then in with the mushrooms and season with salt and pepper. In with the garlic and spinach and cook till it looks like this. A teaspoon of dried basil, half a stock cube, and add some hot water. Add your pasta and try to make it submerged as soon as possible. Add your milk and bring it to the boil. Stir every minute because this will burn.
Add cheddar cheese, taste for seasoning, and drop a like and a follow.
We're making quesadillas. Start by frying your eggs, cooking and seasoning them, and topping them off with a tortilla wrap. Flip it over and top it off with grated mozzarella cheese, guacamole, and salsa dip. Spread it all out and fold it in half. Cook for 2 minutes on each side, and if you're hungry for more, give me a follow. Yeah, you got that yummy, yum, that yummy, yum, that yummy, yummy. Yeah, you got that yummy, yum, that yummy, yum, that yummy, yummy. Say the word on my way. Yeah, babe, yeah, babe, yeah, babe.
Y'all thinking what I'm thinking? Let's go cook some food. Lidl, let's go. I don't want to buy a steak from Lidl, but I got no choice right now, so fuck it. Okay, go on, fucking put your vegetables down. Get your steak out, because it needs to be room temperature when you cook it. Chop up that stuff, get it cooking, stab it, and then drain it. It's got to be really dry, like as dry as a nun, because, you know, then it'll fry well. Make sure your oil is hot, chop them up, stab them up, and have a little sing.
Yo, big up Stormzy.
All right, guys, this is when shit gets serious now. You got to cook your steak, so the pan has got to be really, really hot. You got to season it well, and don't add pepper until halfway through cooking, or it will burn. Just fucking cook the steak, and then you can take your little baby trees and the rest of your rabbit food and cook that. So I already know the bloody comments are going to be saying, Nathan, the cow's still running around like it's still pink. Okay, you're not eating it. I am. Cook it how you want to cook it. But more butter, more delicious, more fucking tasty. And if you don't rest your meat, you're a pleb. So just fucking cut it all up and play it together, and then there's not much more than that. Enjoy with water, red wine, or Ribena.
Empty out the clip. I swear I'm too official, I can never stress a bitch. I done lost a couple soldiers every day, I reminisce. And I could've took his bitch, but her pussy smell like fish. Me and all my niggas on a ship like marijuana. Only time a nigga hit my phone is when it's drama. Niggas feel a type of way, cause I do what I wanna. While you was scared of sharks, I was posted with piranhas. I heard that you freaky, maybe you should teach me. I'm afraid to tell you how these other bitches treat me. You don't gotta worry, I'ma pull up when you need me. How my bitch bad is what I wonder, like I'm Stevie. I know it's been way too long. I know niggas did you wrong.
Homemade salsa is a million times better than shop bought.
Cut one way down the tomato,
hold it all together,
do one slice into the tomato,
then slice across the tomato.
Use about 5 tomatoes and half a chili.
Roll up the coriander
before running the knife through it. You need to be using a sharp knife for all this. Same technique on the red onion as with the tomato, and the same even with the garlic. After chopping the garlic, add salt and olive oil and mash it with your knife to create sort of a garlic puree. This makes sure even distribution. One large clove is enough. The juice of half a lime, season with plenty of salt, pepper, and extra virgin olive oil. And drop a like and a follow.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, that's not serious. Hey. Walk up in a
Super too clean, I froze. They don't fight you where I'm from. Like the beat, I keep a drum. You ain't got dough, little boy, you a.
I wanna go one on one with you. One on one. And I want you to want me too. You one on one. I wanna go one on one with you. Take the thug in me and put some in you. Now you wearing bandanas, rocking your man's flannels. Flight to Dubai, gotta pop a Xanax. Me no love for them body boy antics. Gon' make me you poor choppers out the attic. I'm a savage, straight savage. Yeah, they laughed at my dreams of living lavish. Be no pretender, we both remember. All these was ghosts before I had the phantom. Before I had the gram, I couldn't get at them.
Hash browns are for wimps. You can do better. We're making a potato galette. It's French. Peel one large potato. Cheesecloth. Grate. Twist and ring. Ring out the excess moisture. Heat 8-inch skillet, medium low heat. Add 2 to 3 tablespoons canola oil, peanut oil, or leftover bacon fat. Add half of the potato. Freshly grated Parmigiano Reggiano. Remaining potato on top. Salt. Cook 5 to 6 minutes until golden on the bottom. Turn up the heat to medium to make sure it's nice and golden. 1 to 2 minutes. See how it's nicely golden around the edges? It's time to flip. Flip. Add a little more oil so it doesn't burn. Cook medium low heat 5 to 6 more minutes. Salt, pepper, parsley, Parmigiano Reggiano, dill. Oh yeah.
Grok Boys mac and cheese, let's get it. Cook your pasta slightly under al dente. You're going to rinse it, cold water, put it in half pans, add granulated garlic, cracked black pepper, and Parmesan cheese. On top, add any 3 cheese mixture you want, half a cup of milk in each pan, and then you're going to mix it up so it looks like this. Melt some butter, Velveeta cheese, you're going to mix it. Mix it and mix it. We're not adding flour. It's not going to be a roux. You're going to add some milk, about a cup at a time. Melt down now that Velveeta until it looks like this, nice and smooth. Pour that over top of your mixture of mac and cheese. This is going to be your cheese sauce. Mix that up. Once it's mixed thoroughly, you're still going to have that whole shredded cheese in there. You're going to top the pan with more shredded cheese, 300 degrees in the oven for about 30 minutes. Take it out, stir it up, mix it together in the oven for another 30, and here's what you got. Insert epic cheese pull.
At home, KFC popcorn chicken. Let's go.
Sanitize your hands so we don't get corona.
Dice your chicken in by 1 centimeter cubes, and then chuck that in a bowl with some buttermilk and allow to marinate between 15 minutes to half an hour. Fill up a deep fryer with vegetable oil and preheat it to 180 degrees Celsius. In a bowl of plain flour, add smoked paprika, garlic powder, onion powder, chicken salt, and then give it a good mix to combine.
Now the oil's up to temperature, we're ready to cook.
Drain the marinated chicken and dust it thoroughly in the flour mixture. Carefully place the chicken into the deep fryer. Deep fry until golden brown.
Remove the chicken from the oil and drain into a bowl lined with paper towel.
Dust generously with chicken salt and give it a good shake to season.
And there you have homemade popcorn chicken. Dig in and enjoy.
Today we're making my take on the KFC Go Bucket. Start off by peeling your potatoes and cutting them into chips. Chuck them into a freezer bag and microwave for about 5 minutes or until soft. Tip the microwave potatoes onto a tray lined with paper towel. Cut up your chicken breast into small cubes. Fill up a bowl with panko breadcrumbs. And in the second bowl, make an egg wash out of 2 eggs and some milk. Chuck your chicken breast into a freezer bag, add some flour and give it a good shake. Dust off the flour and chuck it in the egg mixture. Then chuck it into the breadcrumbs and coat all over. Chuck your chips into a preheated deep fryer at 190 degrees Celsius. Now it's time to cook the chicken. Add your mini popcorn chicken to a fry pan with some vegetable oil and cook until golden brown on every side. Drain your chips when golden brown. Season your chips with chicken salt, and now it's time to dish up. And there you have your very own KFC Go Bucket.
So today I really wanted to try to make churros, so I added a cup of water, half a cup of butter, a tablespoon of sugar, and boiled that on high. Then mix it around a bit, put in the flour, cut off the heat before flour, mix that around, added some vanilla, mix it more, transferred it to this bowl, added an egg, and mix it with a hand mixer. It was still kind of lumpy, so mix it with this spoon. And then I got a piping tip and bag, put the dough inside there, and I wanted to make some long churros, like at Disney. So I did that, put in the freezer, oil to the pot, and then made my cinnamon sugar mixture. All you gotta do is squeeze out the dough, cut it with scissors, and it falls right into the oil. Take it out when it's golden brown, place on some paper, and don't let it dry too much because you want it to stick to the cinnamon sugar. Now I'm frying my long boys until they're golden brown, put in some sugar on that, and then here's the finished product. It was so good and so yummy.
Start with that chicken thigh, pat it dry. Get them all in a bowl. Season them all with Tabasco, cayenne, salt, pepper, and garlic powder. Mix it up until it looks just like that. 2 cups of flour, cayenne, paprika, cornstarch, salt, and pepper. Mix it up. That's the flour mix. 2 eggs, buttermilk. You know, want to mix that up. Pour that over the chicken. Mix up the chicken. Get it in there and let it sit. Then coat the chicken very well in the flour. Spicy mayonnaise, paprika, cayenne, Tabasco, simple mix. Oil in, check that it's hot enough. Has to be hot enough, you wanna hear that noise. Chicken thigh, 5 to 6 minutes each side, golden brown, and then flip. After that, take it out, just like that. Toasted brioche bun, spicy mayonnaise, both sides, pickles, that chicken, top it. Yes,
Okay, look, I got Pizza the Hut before, I'll do it again.
1 cup of water. 1.5 teaspoons of instant yeast.
It's a little mixy-mixy.
Sit for 5 minutes. 2.5 cups of all-purpose flour. 2 teaspoons of sugar. 1.25 teaspoons of fine sea salt.
Whiskey business. Add your yeasty water and mix. Take it a rough dough. Put it to a work surface. Just keep kneading.
Come nice and smooth.
Medium bowl. A little drizzle of olive oil. Shape your dough into a ball, into your bowl. Plastic wrap, lightly oiled. Cover.
Rise at room temperature 1 to 2 hours. Italian tomatoes.
Tomato. 2 cloves of garlic. 2 tablespoons of olive oil. Salt to taste. Pinch of sugar.
Blend. Tell nice and smooth.
Pizza stone.
Into the oven. 500 Fahrenheit.
45 minutes. Baking sheet. Dust generously with flour.
Any flour. Dump out your dough. Divide. 2 even pieces. And shape. Into a ball. Onto your sheet. Cover and rest.
30 minutes. Pizza peel with flour. Piece of dough. Flour on the top. Punch around the perimeter. Over the knuckles. Turn, stretch, turn, stretch. Little pizza sauce. Spread it out.
Cheese.
Pepperoni. Into the oven on the 5 minutes.
Broil 2 minutes.
Garlic oil on the crusty.
Confesándome, okay. Pa' ver una película besándote. Si tienes ganas de comer, tú solo dime. Para empezar a calentarme aquí en el cine.
Today we're making grilled chicken gyros, not gyros, gyros. It's Greek. 1.5 pound boneless skinless chicken breast. Pound the hump so it cooks evenly. 1/3 cup olive oil. Grate 2 garlic cloves. Grated zest of 1 lemon. Marinate up to 4 hours in the refrigerator. Now we make tzatziki. 1 garlic clove, grated. 1 tablespoon lemon juice. It mellows the garlic. 7 ounces Greek yogurt. 1/3 English cucumber. Peel, remove the seeds. Grate, dash of cayenne, pinch of salt. Stir. 2 tablespoons chopped dill. 5 pocket osteta, wrap in foil. 350 degrees, 15 minutes. Heat grill over medium heat. Salt, pepper. Oil grates. Grill 4 to 5 minutes each side. Remove to rest, 8 minutes. Slice.
Okay, so you're at... Y'all are asking for fried chicken, but you didn't say which kind. I think we should do something special.
Start with some chicken breast. Put that on a layer of plastic wrap. Chicken, another layer of plastic wrap.
Beat that bit. 1/2 inch thick. Repeat with all your chicken.
Season both sides with salt.
In three separate containers. 3 eggs. Splash of water. With a whisk. Whiskey business. 2 cups of all-purpose flour.
2 cups of panko breadcrumbs.
Welcome to the breading station.
Both sides in flour. Shake up excess. Then the egg. Both sides, obviously. And then...
Cook well in panko.
Look at that.
Repeat with the rest.
Deep skillet.
High heat oil,
put half an inch deep.
Pan stove,
a little over medium heat.
Until the oil is hot at about 350 Fahrenheit.
Carefully lay away from you.
Fry that
for 3 to 4 minutes.
Flip and fry another
2 to 4 minutes.
The wire rack.
Now that is a crispy.
Katsu sauce.
That's looking about right, but I think we need a little extra.
Oh yeah, we got the sauce.
Yes, sir.